Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about fungus Albugo candida. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about the vegetative structure of Albugo and its asexual and sexual modes of reproduction. Let us start with the introduction to fungus Albugo. Albugo candida is also known as Cystopus candidens. Albugo is the only genus of the family Albuginaceae belonging to class Oomycetes. It is an obligate endoparasite distributed all over the world. The fungus is the causal agent of white rust disease of crucifers. It attacks several annual crucifers such as Brassica campestris, Rafanus sativus, etc. It invades all the parts of the plant which are above the ground. Roots are not infected. The disease appears in the form of shiny, white, irregular raised patches or pustules or blisters on the aerial parts of the plant. White rust disease is otherwise known as blister rust disease. The patches gradually turn powdery. The disease causes deformation of the inflorescence axis of the host. Increase in size of cells, known as hypertrophy, takes place, resulting in the formation of large galls on the host plant. In severe cases, discoloration of flowers, proliferation of the lateral buds are also seen. The carpels along with ovules are atrophied, causing sterility. Let us look into the vegetative structure of Albugo. The thallus is eucarpic. It consists of intercellular, profusely branched, aseptate, cenocytic mycelium. Cell wall of the fungus is made up of fungal cellulose. Protoplasm consists of cytoplasm and a number of nuclei. Reserve food material is in the form of oil drops and glycogen bodies. The mycelium enters the host through the stomata. The intercellular mycelium forms knob-like outgrowths known as haustoria, which absorbs nutrients from the host plant. Therefore, mode of nutrition of fungus Albugo is heterotrophic. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, we shall discuss about reproduction in Albugo. The fungus reproduces both asexually as well as sexually. The asexual reproductive organs are known as conidia, conidiosporangia, or zoosporangia. The mycelium beneath the epidermis of the stem or leaf form dense masses of hyphae. They give rise to many erect, unbranched, club-shaped structures called conidiophores. They contain cytoplasm and a number of nuclei. The conidiophores are short, run parallel to each other, thick-walled, unbranched, palisade-like cells, and are perpendicular to the surface of the host plant. The tips of the conidiophores become swollen due to the accumulation of excess food. At maturity, the apical portion of the conidiophores cut off, forming a bud which gets separated from it by a transverse partition. This bud is known as conidium, conidiosporangium, or zoosporangium. Beneath the conidium, a chain of conidia is formed from one conidiophore in basipetal succession. That is, the youngest conidium is at the base and the oldest at the top. In between two conidia, a gelatinous disc-like structure called disjunctor or separation disc or intercalary disc is present. When the conidia are mature, epidermis ruptures and exposes the white powdery mass of dust-like conidiospores and hence the name white rust. The mass contains numerous conidia or conidiosporangia or zoosporangia which are dispersed by wind or rain water. Each conidium is a spherical multinucleate structure with dense cytoplasm and thin wall. Germination of the zoosporangia may be direct or indirect depending upon the environmental condition. During favorable condition, when the temperature is high and the air is dry, the zoosporangia do not divide but germinate directly by forming a germ tube which infects a new healthy host plant. During favorable condition, in the presence of moisture and low temperature, they show indirect germination. The zoosporangia behave like zoosporangium and produce zoospores which are kidney-shaped and biflagellated. The two flagella are found inserted laterally. The zoospores settle on the host plant, retract their flagella, secrete a wall around, or undergo a period of encystment. They develop a short germ tube which enters the host tissue through the stoma. It produces well-developed intercellular profusely branched mycelium and infects the new healthy host plant. Let us revise the various stages in asexual reproduction with the help of diagram. The somatic mycelium gives rise to conidiophores, which form spherical multinucleate conidium. From the conidium arises the zoosporangium. Depending upon the climatic conditions, it either directly forms a germ tube and infects a new host plant, or the zoosporangium may produce biflagellate kidney-shaped zoospores. After a period of encystment, they develop germ tube and infect new host plant by producing branched mycelium. Next, we shall look into the sexual reproduction in albugo. Sexual reproduction takes place on the disappearance of conidia. In albugo, sexual reproduction is highly oogamous and takes place with the help of male sex organs antheridia and female sex organs oogonia. The two sex organs develop near each other, but on different male and female hyphae. They are formed by the swelling of the intercellular mycelium due to accumulation of dense cytoplasm with a number of nuclei and food granules. The antheridia are club-shaped, while the oogonia are spherical or globular. Both are multinucleate and get separated from the rest of the hypha by a transverse septum. The oogonium in Albugo candida contains number of nuclei, while the antheridium possesses a few nuclei. Both the antheridium and oogonium grow in close association. In both the sex organs, the nuclei present in the cytoplasm undergo mitotic division. The oogonium gets differentiated into a central, denser, uninucleate ooplasm and peripheral, multinucleate periplasm with a plasma membrane separating the two. A single uninucleate egg is left in the center, forming the oosphere, while all other female nuclei disintegrate. The oogonium develops a receptive papilla which pushes within the antheridium. The antheridium sends a fertilization tube, pierces the papilla, makes its way into the periplasm, and finally reaches the oosphere. The tube bursts and releases a single male nucleus into the oosphere. A diploid uninucleate oospore is formed by the fusion of the male nucleus with the egg. Next is germination of oospore. The oospore has a thick wall with three distinct layers: a tuberculate epispore, the exospore, and the endospore. When mature, the oospore of Albugo candida first undergoes meiotic division, followed by a number of mitotic divisions to produce 32 nuclei in each. During favorable season, the oospores resume their germination. The nuclei undergo a number of mitotic divisions, forming numerous nuclei. Each nucleus is surrounded by protoplasm and forms biflagellate reniform zoospores. The wall of the oospore ruptures. A thin vesicle is formed containing the mass of zoospores. With the disappearance of the vesicle, the zoospores are liberated. After a brief period of motility, they get encysted and then finally germinate by germ tubes infecting healthy host plants. Let us revise the various stages in sexual reproduction with the help of a diagram. The antheridium and oogonium are in close association with each other. When mature, the oogonium forms uninucleate ooplasm and multinucleate periplasm. A single uninucleate egg forms the oosphere. The male nucleus reaches the egg with the help of fertilization tube. The male nucleus and the egg fuse to form diploid uninucleate oospore, which after a sequence of divisions gives rise to biflagellate reniform zoospores. The zoospores, after liberation, get encysted and finally form germ tube and infect a new host plant by producing branched mycelium. So today, we have learnt in detail about the vegetative structure of fungus Albugo candida and its various modes of reproduction. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notifications of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.